हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम संपदा कुलकर्णी वेलकम्स यू इन माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स। हियर इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द कंसेप्ट ऑफ ट्री डेटा स्ट्रक्चर वेयर आई एम कवरिंग ऑल द थिंग्स रिलेटेड टू ट्री डेटा स्ट्रक्चर। बिफोर मूविंग टू द कंटेंट आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स एंड कीप द बेल रिंगिंग। Here in this slide I am briefing you about the binary tree traversal techniques. They are depth first search traversal technique and the breadth first search traversal technique. Depth first search traversal techniques are also called as DFS and breadth first traversal techniques are also called as BFS. DFS further divided into three ways in which we can traverse a binary tree. They are pre-order, in-order and post-order. Basically, they depend on the position of a root node. And the breadth first traversal technique is nothing but the level order traversal technique. If you want to know more about tree traversal techniques, binary tree traversal technique, here I am providing you a shortcut link in this right-up corner, which will help you to know all the details about binary tree traversal. In this video, I am covering the concept of post-order traversal. So, from the binary tree traversal, let's see the post-order traversal. The post-order traversal for a given tree where we supposed to follow a sequence is nothing but left subtree, a right subtree and a root node. So, now after starting with a root node, we are not going to process it, but we have to move to its left child. After that we have to process its left child, then to move to the right child, as our next step is to moving to a right child of a current root node, we should have to return back to the root node. As we have to return back to the root node and then we will move to the right child. After moving to the right child, let's process it and then again return back to a root node to process a root node as a last, because in the last we are going to process a root node. Now, as I explained previously that for moving to the previous level, that is from left child to the root node, and for moving from a right child to the root node, here how we have to return back, as we don't have any back links available. There are only the link from a parent node to the child node, but from a child node or to move to from a child node to a root node, there is no any backlink is available. So for that, how we can return back to the previous level or to the parent node? So we are having a solution for that, and the solution is recursive and non-recursive algorithm. Recursive algorithm for post-order traversal I have already explained in my previous session. You can go through that for your reference. I am providing a shortcut link in this write-up corner, and here in this session I am focusing on a non-recursive algorithm. So the heart of this video session is nothing but non-recursive post-order binary tree traversal. The non-recursive post-order binary tree traversal follows the sequence, first of all left subtree, then right subtree and then a root node. For this we are having a non-recursive algorithm as follows. Here you can see that this is nothing but the function post order, where there are 5 steps, in which the step number 1 is to check my tree is not null. If my tree is null, return from a function. Otherwise, if my tree is not null, go to the step number 2. What my step number 2 says? Step number 2 says that we have to create 2 stacks, S1 and S2 respectively, of the data type structure node, because these 2 stacks, both of the stacks, we are going to use to store, to push the nodes onto it. Now here we are creating the explicit stack, as this is nothing but the depth first search traversal technique, and before moving to the depth we supposed to store the current level onto the stack, because the behavior of the stack is last in first out, and it helps us to return back to the previous level or to the parent node. If you want to know more about the stack data structure, you can click over here. I am providing you a shortcut link for a stack data structure and all the details for a stack data structure. So now let's hope that all of you are knowing the concept of stacks, and let's move to the next step. After creation of two stacks, we have to push a root node into the stack one. So on a first stack, we are going to push a root node. After this, my step number 4, I have to execute it till my stack 1 is not empty. Here, first step is which we are going to execute continuously till my condition is true. The first step is popping the top of the stack from S1, and that we have to push it onto the S2, that is stack number 2. After this, after performing this operation, we again have to push a left and a right child respectively if present for the popped node to S1. And after this you have to continue till my S1 is not empty, and if it is S1 is empty, print all the contents of a second stack, that is S2. Now why we supposed to follow the sequence left and right child, that I will explain you when I'll dry run this code for the example. Let's move to the next slide, where this is the algorithm for your reference. This is the example which I am going to explain you for the dry run of this code. So let's start with the creation of the stack. That is, the first step is to check my tree is not empty. Yes, it is not empty, so that's why I create a stack 1 and S2. So this is stack 1 and this is my stack 2. After this, what we have to do, we have to push a root node onto the stack. Here you can see that A is a root node, and you just observe the behavior of S1. Here I have pushed the node A onto the stack. After this, step number 4 is, we have to execute the step number 4.1 and 4.2, this should be 4.1 and 4.2, continuously till my S1 is not empty. So that's why first step is to pop the top of the stack, that is A I have to pop, and that I have to push onto the stack 2. So here you just observe the behavior of S1 and S2 both, that is, I am popping the content from S1 and I am pushing it onto the stack 2. After this, you have to push a left and right child respectively if present for the popped node. Which one is the popped node? It was A. Which one is its left child? Its left child is B, that I am going to push first, and then a right child C that I am going to push onto the stack 1 again. Again, you have to check whether my S1 is empty or not empty. It is not empty, condition is true, so that's why pop top of the stack. So I am popping C from a S1 and that I am pushing onto the S2. And after that, let's check whether the left and right child are present to the popped element or not. They are not present, so that's why we are not performing any operation, push operation onto the S1. We'll check again that S1 is empty or not empty. S1 is not empty, so that's why we have to perform a pop operation on S1. So let's pop it, that I'm going to pop C and I'm going to push it onto the stack S2. After pushing it, let's check again whether the popped item is having its left and right child. Here you can see that no any left and right child is present, so that's why we are again skipping this step and will return back to check whether S1 is empty or not empty. Here you can see that S1 is empty, so that's why we will not enter into the while loop and it will go for the step number 5. Here I would like to explain you why we have followed the sequence left and right child. Because stack is having the behavior of last in first out, so that's why as we have inserted B first, that is a left child, and C after that, C is popped first and inserted in this stack 2 first, then B is popped and inserted over here, and as in the post order traversal we supposed to traverse a left first, so that's why which one is the top of the stack is nothing but the last element which was inserted in a stack is nothing but left. B is on top of the stack, and now here we have to pop B which was inserted last into the stack. So let's perform the step number 5, execute the step number 5, where we have to print the content of the stack 2. So let's pop the first element and display it in a post order traversal, that is B. Then pop top of the stack C and display it in post order, and now top of the stack is A, pop it and display it. So in this way you will find out the post order traversal for the given binary tree. So thank you dear friends for listening and watching my video. If you are having any query, you can post your query in the comment box. I'll try to solve it. If you like the video and the content, please do not forget to give the comment and please do not forget to share it with your friends. Here I am providing you a shortcut link for a subscription of my channel. Please do subscribe my channel, and for your reference I am providing you next video of this video series in this slide, as well as the whole video series I am providing you in the form of playlist. Thank you. Stay tuned with Tech Talks, and happy learning, happy data structuring. Thank you.